Hey guys, it's Benjamin with Benjamin's Exotics, and in today's Morph Guide, we're going to be taking a look at the ball python that is responsible for producing some of the most beautiful blue-eyed leucistic ball pythons that have ever existed on the ball python market today, which is, of course, the lesser ball python. So let's first take a look at a standard lesser ball python. So this is a lesser het clown female that I've been raising up, but again, het clown is not gonna have that much, if any, impact on the overall look of the snake. So right off the bat, compared to a normal, you guys can see this is a big, big difference. Not only are we getting all of this kind of, I don't even know how to describe it. It's like a Mojave color, but you throw in a little bit more brown, a little bit more tan-ish going down the back of this snake, and all of this blushing, a lot like the pastels that we talked about in a previous morph guide. So you guys can see, this is just really no question compared to a normal. And look at all that blushing on the sides in these alien head kind of bracket type things. All of that blushing and gray really comes out when you start to put this with other combos like Enchi, pinstripe, stuff like that. Completely different from a normal, but in case any of you guys did want to compare this to a normal, I can actually grab one right behind me. This should be a big normal male. And I mean, once you guys see this, there is no question. And this is another one of those morphs that I really don't think people are going to have that much trouble identifying a normal from a lesser. I mean, there you go. Completely no question. Brighter, the blushing is different, the alien heads are even a little bit more jumbled up. Not as much as a Mojave or a black pastel, but definitely a little bit different from a normal. And even the head, look how light and blushed out that head is compared to what you get on a normal. Just completely different from these two snakes. Now, one of the cool things about the lessers, and I'm actually going to talk about the super form in today's video, is that when you breed two of these guys together, this is actually what you're going to get, or these are the genes that you need. The super form of this gene is what is needed to produce the blue-eyed leucistic ball python. So the blue-eyed Lucy, a little bit of a weird way to say it, and she's kind of going under the table. But when you breed two of these guys together, you're actually going to get a completely white snake that is going to have blue eyes. So one of the things with lesser, like you guys just saw, a lesser is very far from a normal, and most people aren't going to have a problem identifying this compared to a normal just because of how different it is. But one main thing that I would like to show you guys is lesser versus Mojave. Lots of times you go on forums, you see on Instagram, YouTube comments, stuff like that. People are asking, you know, what is the difference between a lesser and Mojave? How do I identify the difference? And I actually have a Mojave with me that I produced sometime, well, actually it was the middle of this year, so in the middle of 2019. And this is one of the holdbacks that I have. And as you can see, as they age, very clear difference between these two snakes. However, believe it or not, as a baby, I've seen some very light Mojaves that look really similar to lessers, and I've seen some very dark lessers that look pretty similar to Mojaves. So in the case that we were looking at two babies, and let's say that you bred Mojave to Mojave, or sorry, let's say you bred these two snakes together, Mojave to lesser, which if you guys don't know, like we talked about earlier, the lesser to lesser combination makes a blue-eyed Lucy, but so does breeding a lesser to a Mojave. You add a little bit more pattern into the snake, but still a pretty white snake. So if we were gonna breed these two guys together and you popped out some offspring and you weren't quite sure which one was which, here are some indicators that you can use. So firstly, let's look at the blushing on these snakes. Like we talked about on the Mojave, or sorry, on the lesser. Down the back of the lesser's back, we see all of this blushing, very similar to a pastel, which is one of the reasons why lesser works so good with pastel. And the blushing effect is also on the back and also on the sides. Look at how much blushing goes through on the side. All that blushing there, this is the Mojave, but this is, I'm talking about the lesser, of course. All that blushing on the sides, just completely different from what you'd see with a normal. Now when we look at the Mojave, we're not gonna see nearly the same effect. So if we look on the back, again, you might have a little bit of blushing right there, but it's gonna be a much darker black, and really, the blushing is very, I mean, it's nothing compared to what you have on the lesser. Now, on the sides of the Mojaves, you will have some blushing, actually quite nice blushing in this case compared to a normal, but the coloration is what we're really looking for. So look on the lesser. See how we're getting this like really greenish kind of coloration, and actually you will see kind of gray coming through on this blushing. We kind of get a more tan effect on the Mojaves. This will get more gray with age, but you know, it's just all of this greenish kind of gray. I don't know how to describe the color. You can see the difference right there. The blushing on the Mojave versus the blushing on the Lesser. Completely different thing what we're talking about, okay? So that is one of the main indicators that I will use. And if you did have a Mojave that was like really blushed out, another indication you can use is the head. So if we actually look at the head, and this is actually gonna be pretty difficult now that I think about this. Let's look at the head, first of all, just on the standard Lesser. If we can get the camera to focus, pretty, I mean, standard head. We actually have a lot more blushing than you would on a normal, and the coloration of the brown is like that, very blushed out. And then if we take a look at the Mojave in comparison, I would like to get these guys to cooperate and show both of their heads, but I don't think that's gonna happen in today's video. If we look at the Mojave head, just so much more black. Okay, there we go. If we can get that guy to hold still in this Lesser to cooperate. Again, these guys are a little bit runny today. Not runny, that's probably not the best word to use. A little bit feisty, just they don't like these bright lights. But if we look at the head on the Lesser, come on, buddy. Head on the Lesser compared to the head on the Mojave. Again, there we go. There we go. Look at the difference. Huge, massive difference, okay? So if what you did have a Mojave that had a lot of blushing or Lesser that was very dark, the head on those guys, no question, this is a Lesser, and that is the head on a Mojave. And again, that has to all do with the blushing and the coloration and stuff like that. Another thing you can use, this isn't quite as accurate because there is a lot of variation with Mojaves and Lessers, but when we're looking at the alien heads, see how on the Lesser you have like more reduced and the alien heads are actually blend together more. So these alien heads are all kind of, you know, in some cases blending together, like a lot on the tail, that's actually pretty reduced, but on this side, that blending is a lot what you see, or I should say you see that a lot with your Lessers, okay? And Lessers can really have some crazy blending together with the alien heads. On the Mojaves, we're really talking more of what I call portholes, okay? So see how we have the reduction almost disconnected from the root of where the alien head would normally come up. Like a Lesser has the root that actually goes down to the stomach. It's disconnected a lot of the times on the Mojave, and we're talking about a more reduced snake. We'll also see the Mojave kind of throw part of the alien head up into the back, which you can get sometimes sort of with the Lessers, but not really. Like you can see, look at the difference. That one's kind of connected to there, whereas on the Mojaves, we have like an entire alien head thrown up into the back. So hopefully that gives you guys a pretty good clarification on the differences between Mojaves and Lessers. And oh, by the way, there's also one more difference I want to talk about, which is actually the belly. Now I can't show you on this snake because this snake is still, you know, quite young and it's a baby, but as these guys get into adulthood, the belly on the Mojave is going to change in most cases, and the belly on the Lesser will not. Okay, so if this snake decides to not cooperate like those other guys were not cooperating, this is going to be a lot more difficult to do, but I actually have, if I can get her out and let go of the thing, there is a big, big Mojave female. This is like 4,000 grams plus. I'm gonna try to grab the Lesser as well. So as you guys can see, even with the adults, again, same time of thing, this is a different Mojave, of course. I didn't make it grow magically in a few seconds, but again, kind of just to verify, you can see blushing, no blushing for the most part on this Mojave. What I wanted to show you guys is the belly. So as these animals start to mature and start to get a little bit of age on them, for whatever reason, and again, this can be a little bit variable, but I've seen on lots of the Mojaves, you're gonna get some amount of gray. Sometimes it's barely any gray at all. Sometimes it's like this girl and you get a lot of gray. So again, this is actually a very strong, heavy snake, and this is gonna be very hard to maneuver her because she's grabbing onto everything that she can. Come on, girl. Let go of the table. But look at that. That is the belly of a big, big Mojave female. All of that gray you see coming in with age. And again, whether it's a male, female, whatever, they might not get that much gray. This is a, you know, fantastic example of that gray. But as an adult, most of your Mojaves are gonna get kind of that more gray color. Okay, now there's no way she's gonna stay still, but if we go ahead and try to show a Lesser female, okay, or I should say the Lesser female that we were showing earlier, the belly on these guys, it'll focus, completely white. okay, not even close to that of the Mojave. Again, even when these guys get older, I've never seen a lesser with barely any gray, if any gray at all, on the belly. This is a very, very almost pure white belly color. There's like this slight yellowish tint, sort of, but I mean, you compare that to the belly on the Mojave, and man, this snake is, I mean, once this snake grabs onto stuff, I cannot get her to move. That's why this video is gonna be a little bit harder. Okay, I'm gonna have to move to the side, guys, trying to get her. This is a massive ball python. I can't even, come on. If we look at the belly of the Mojave again, if we can get a side-by-side comparison, again, I don't know how good this is gonna come out on the camera, but look at the difference. The gray, I mean, there's no question about it. Look at the difference of those two snakes. No question that this is a lesser, and this big girl right here is a Mojave. Now, before we did go ahead and end today's video, I want to talk to you guys a little bit more about the blushing, because I think lots of the times on these morph guides and stuff, I'll talk about blushing and I'll just act like it's basically a way to identify an animal compared to maybe another morph, but blushing is a lot more than that. Blushing can actually give us a pretty good idea of how this animal is going to act when we put it with other genes. So one thing I did want to talk about is, given a quick comparison, I just showed you guys Mojave, and a Mojave is a very similar gene to lesser. Again, they're both kind of in that blue-eyed leucistic complex. They both make snakes that are pretty white with blue eyes. The Mojave is, again, going to have more of that gray head and gray pattern going down the back, but I really think it's important to understand what this blushing does when we put it with other morphs. So I'm going to go ahead and going to actually put up a picture right now of a Mojave pastel, okay? As you guys can see, that's what we would call Pastavi. That's actually the combination of the two genes, and that is a Mojave pastel. Now, compared to that Mojave that we just saw a little bit earlier, you guys can probably notice that that Mojave pastel, called a Pastavi, is very, very dominant. You can actually see the Mojave coming out in it a lot more than you can see the pastel. It kind of just looks like a Mojave that has a little bit more of a lighter color to it, if you will. You can definitely tell it's not just a single gene Mojave, but it looks really, you know, the Mojave is dominating, okay? Now, you guys might be like, you know, what's your point? Now let's look at a pastel lesser, okay? So a lesser pastel, either way. And here is a picture of a lesser pastel. And as you can see, a lot different. Instead of there really being one dominating force where the pastel is dominating or the lesser is dominating, these snakes are basically coming together to form this really bright, vibrant, and interesting looking snake. And that actually has to do partially with the blushing. When we see the blushing, we're not simply talking about a trait that is on the snake, we're talking about blending, okay, and how dominant a trait is. And so, since on the lesser, we see all of this crazy blushing and all of this really crazy, you know, it could be blushing on the back, blushing on the sides, all of this blushing, this is actually signaling a gene that is a little bit less dominant. And that is actually a good thing and a bad thing. With these genes that are a little bit less dominant, like the lessers that have the blushing, when we put this with other genes that are very dominant, we can actually, unfortunately, start to get some stuff that's a little bit washed out. So if we look at something like a lesser clown, we can do a lesser clown versus a Mojave clown, like you guys can see, the lesser clown is a lot more washed out, and the Mojave clown is a lot more, you know, dominant, and it's more vibrant. It has more contrast than the lesser, and that can be a downside to the blushing. However, when we start putting lesser together with other things like pastel, super pastel, even to a certain effect, things like spot nose and clown, all of these genes that kind of encourage blushing or that are receptive to blushing genes, we can actually start to create things that are even more impressive that you cannot do with the Mojave gene. So it's not just simply that lessers have blushing and Mojaves don't. It's the entire kind of spectrum of this gene. And I actually have a pastel behind me. Let me grab one real quick. If we look at a pastel, oh, that's a normal. If we look at a pastel, kind of like this, like I've been talking about, pastels also have that kind of blushing kind of pattern going down their back. And this girl is gonna run from me, isn't she? But as you can see, maybe not even as much as the lesser, but still, all of that blushing going down the snake's back, okay? Very, you know, standard for your pastels to have all kinds of crazy blushing going down the back, similar to your lesser. So that basically signals that we're talking about a gene that is a little bit less dominant, okay, a gene that is gonna have a little bit, maybe more problems with contrast when we start putting it with other genes, things like clown, maybe things like pied, even things like spider, as compared to like orange dream. I lots of the times I think, you know, in terms of the blushing spectrum, you know, lesser, kind of is like with pastel, and the opposite of those genes in this kind of spectrum is like the opposite of lesser with blushing is Mojave, and the opposite of blushing with the pastel is like orange dream, okay? And by themselves, orange dream, Mojave, that kind of stuff are a lot more powerful than these other genes like pastel and lesser, okay? But when you start to take these genes that do have this blushing and combine them together, so one of the things that I can think of right now is like a super pastel lesser spot Spotnose clown, okay? All of those genes except spotnose are really blushing genes. And when you put those together, we can create something that is just fantastic. And I'll actually put a picture up right now. I believe it was American Royals, I believe is what the name of their company is. If it's wrong, I'll definitely put a name on the picture. But if you look at that snake right there, that is a super pastel lesser spotnose clown. And we get all of these crazy pinks and yellow, orangish colors, and as this snake gets older, it's only gonna get better and better. And that is all due to the blushing. If we would have tried to change those genes out for other genes, so let's say that instead of being a super pastel lesser spotnose clown, it was instead a super orange dream Mojave spotnose clown, we wouldn't be getting all of those dramatic, crazy, you know, pink, yellow, orangish type colors along the snake's backs and on the side, okay, along the snake's back and along the sides of the snake, okay? That is all part of the blushing coming together, and that spot nose really giving it the boost that it needs to form a truly impressive snake that's gonna look great as not only as a baby and as an adult. So hopefully that gives you guys a very, very, very in-depth idea about this blushing along the back, okay? When you see this from now on, or at least this is how I've always looked at it, when I'm analyzing a gene, we're not just saying the blushing is kind of like a characteristic trait. It tells a story about which genes this particular snake is gonna go really, really well with, and maybe some other genes that it wouldn't go well with, you know? So hopefully this gives you guys, again, it's a very, very long analogy, a very in-depth analogy, but hopefully I'm making sense and you guys can kind of see that there's a place for both the very bold genes, so things like Mojave and Orange Dream, and then also their counterparts, lesser, pastel, stuff like that. Even clown is a blushing gene, okay? And when we start to put the blushing genes together and the really dominant, powerful Orange Dream, Mojave type stuff together, we really start to create snakes that are working together, and we can produce stuff that just doesn't make sense. Really, really interesting ball python morphs that we can create if we understand what genes work together and which genes do not. So I hope you guys did enjoy and most importantly benefit from today's video. Again, the lesser gene is just such an interesting gene, and with going into the entire complex about how the blushing genes work together is an entire subject that I will try to cover more in depth in a future video. If you guys did enjoy today's video, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Until next time, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.